Hello friend, Alok singh here. So in this video we are going to discuss the most awaiting topic, date dependent view of Ecdis. So what is date dependent view on the Ecdis? On ENC if you see, many objects are there, many markings are there, like any TSS, any fairway channel or something in their precautionary area or something, which was not on the ENC at certain date, but after certain date it was implemented, it was included in the ENC. So that means if you want to see when that object was not there, you'll have to integrate that object. Then you'll see in the information column date will be mentioned there. Means if you'll go before that day, that object will remove from the ENC. So what exactly, why do we need this date dependent value on the Ecdis? The first thing, when you are planning your passage, that time if your Ecdis is not at real time, means if it is suppose some earlier time, then might be that object, means few object which is actually on ENC at this time, and your Ecdis is not on the real time, then that object will not be visible on the chart. So if you are going to plot the passage, you will not follow that particular object, means whatever the object meaning is there for that time. So you will lose that thing. So the thing is, when you are planning your passage, suppose your passage is for next 10 days, you are planning your passage today, but the final stage, means when you are at your destination, you will be reaching after 10 days. So if you put your today date, suppose you are putting in the date dependent value is today date, so the thing which is actually on ENC after 10 days, it will not be visible on your chart, and you will miss that particular precaution or whatever is there. So the date dependent view means we have to put some range of date, and at range of date, what all the objects are there on the ENC will be visible on your ENC, and that will be miss, nothing will be missed, and you will plot your passage very carefully, and you will not miss anything. So we'll just see on the Ecdis what is means how we can remove and how we can put this value. Apart from this, if you see sometime what happens, like suppose something, some any precautionary area or something is there which is in which is active in few range of month, like suppose something is there which is only exist within few months, like suppose from March to July or something. So if you'll not put that range and you will plot the passage, then that thing, and you are within that day, but you're within this month range, and you are plotting your passage, but you have not put that day, then that object will not be visible on the chart. So that is why this date dependent value is very important for passage planning. So I'll just go on the ENC and I'll show you how this object exists on the chart and how we can remove and what is the check. We'll just see on the Ecdis. Yeah, so right now I am somewhere near the Providence, and this is the approach for the Providence, and here if you see, I have a precautionary area here. This precautionary area, I have a TSS over here, TSS over here. So if you see here, it one D mark is mentioned here. D mark is marked here. This is not A, but this is D, and this is the indication for date dependent view. Wherever you will see this D value, means there is something date dependent included in that particular object. You will see here also, it will say here. Here it is D also, means this line is also something means related to date dependent view. Now I will try to see what the date dependent range of this object. So I'll just go to the info, just click on this, Like see, this is the precautionary area. It will see here in the this precautionary area. But date start date is given is 1st June 2009. Means this precautionary area has been implemented on ENC at this date. Means if you will go before this date, 2009, means 1st of June 2009, before then this precautionary area will not exist anymore on the chart. So in the same way, for this one, you'll see here, this is also 1st June of 2009. Now we'll see how it can be removed if you are using any, like my Ecdis is currently on, means there is nothing, you cannot see anything here. Means it is on real time, means at today date. So I'll just go to the date dependent setting. You just go through whatever your Ecdis is. I have date dependent here. Like see, I am using current date. So it is showing because it is 2022, and yeah, so I am using current date here. So now I will change the date and I will try to go before 2009. Like start date, I'll just put something. So it was June, so I'll just go to 2008. Okay, stop date also is just put 2008. That's okay. As soon as I put this date range, if you see here, this precautionary area has gone no more on the chart. So if you see here, just now I'll select the current date. This precautionary area including this TSS is on the chart because my Ecdis is on current date. If I'll put the date before this value, this precautionary area implemented on the chart, so this thing will disappear from the chart. So and if you see here, I have a notification on my Ecdis that this chart is, means I am on the older date, means not in the current date. So I am getting this information over here also, means I need to be on the current date or the date for which you are planning your passage, so that anything in that date of range of date is anything is there on the chart, that will be visible and you can plot your passage more safely. So I'll come back to my current date, and if I'll see everything is visible at that stage. So this is actually about the date dependent view and date dependent. This is the importance of date dependent view, and this is what we have to explain to our inspector when they ask something related to date dependent view. Thank you. I hope this video will be helpful for you, and thank you for watching this video.